people, this is lecture 9 and in this we will learn about the three-phase transformers. Let's look into the three-phase transformers. The operation of three-phase transformer operating principle is similar to the single-phase transformer. Also, it is seen that in electrical power system, power is usually generated and transmitted via power system in three phases, and at generation center the voltage has to be stepped up for economical transmission. At higher voltage, the current on the transmission line will be less and the I2R or the copper losses will be less, so the transmission usually occur at higher voltage. And again, close to the distribution center, this has to be stepped down so that it can be used by the low voltage equipments, and it will be uneconomical to use three single phase transformer to do this function. Also, three phase transformer is more efficient to do this function. Again, the three phase transformer has construction type of core type. In core type transformer, there will be three limbs and the windings will be done on each of these three limbs for the three phases of the transformer. And it is also possible to have a five limb construction in case of a shell type transformer, where the winding will happen on each of the three central limbs of the transformer, and it will have sandwiched interleaved winding of primary and secondary for each phase on each of the three central limbs. So one limb will be for the one phase while the other limbs will be for the other phases of the transformer. The three phase transformer can be connected in many ways, including star, delta, open delta, and zigzag star connection. So in three phase transformer there will be three phase. Normally these phases are R, Y, B, and these three phases or the three primary and three secondary phases can be connected with each other. Like the three primary phases can be grouped in a star connection, or it can also be grouped in a delta connection. So the two three phases of the transformer can be connected in a star star, a star delta, or a delta delta, or a delta star, or delta zigzag forms. These are the mostly used forms. There are also some other connection types which are used for different applications. This is a circuit diagram of a star star connection of or delta delta connection of a transformer. So you can see that in a delta connection, the voltage across any two primary windings, any two primary phases, that is A and B connection, is V, while the voltage between the windings of the transformers, the line to line voltage, is V, while the voltage between the windings, any winding A1, A2, is equal to V, that is just equal to same equal to the line voltage. And again, the current through the primary windings of the transformer are divided by root 3, so the current is reduced in this case, and the voltage is transformed in direct ratio of the transformation ratio. Again, if you trace down this connection, it is seen that the A2 is connected to B2 and B1 is connected to C2 and C1 is connected back to A1, so it forms a delta, and so it is called a delta connection. The other kind of connection is a star connection. So here the line to line voltage between any two phases V, while the voltage between the windings, that is a primary winding of any single phase, is V by 3, that root 3, that is a voltage between the windings of a single phase has been reduced by a margin of root 3. And the same applies to the secondary side also, and the voltage has been transformed in the ratio of the transformation ratio, while the current in the primary and the secondary will remain the same. It is not stepped down, it is I for the primary side, and it is again transformed in the ratio in the secondary side. Also, the connection forms a star, like the A2 is connected to A1 and A1 is connected to C1, and B2 is connected to B1 and B1 is connected to C2. So if you trace, it will form a star. So it is known as a star star connection. Again, the choice between a star and a delta connection depends on, in a star connection, phase to neutral voltage is 1 by root 3 times line voltage, while in delta it is equal to line to line voltage. For very high voltage transformer, star connection on the high voltage side may be 10% cheaper. So using a star connection on a high voltage side, the line to neutral voltage can be reduced by root 3 times, so the insulation requirement can be reduced, so it may be 10 times cheaper. Also, star star is economical for small high voltage systems, while delta delta is suitable for low voltage large transformers, and star delta is most suitable for the distribution and the power systems where a neutral system will be required for a neutral for power system transmission where three phase transformation is required. Also, delta star is more used where a neutral requirement is there for the power distribution systems. That's all. If you like this video, please do subscribe, like and comment.